Store TV. We are in Times Square, the center of the earth. So you see that big ass Harry Potter ad?
Look at this shit. It is out of control.
We fucking... You missed the Diddy one. It was really big. But one day, we'll have a stupidly big ad in Times Square. Just to do it. Just because we'll be that ballin'.
Yes.
Yeah, man. So Times Square is literally the shit.
Signing out.
My approach to music has always been autobiographical. What I'm experiencing right now, you know, where my head's at, that's like what makes it into the music. So if I'm celebrating, if I'm partying, if I'm whatever, or if I'm low as fuck, if I'm like going through it, if I'm questioning everything, if I'm feeling inadequate or not good enough for the world or like dealing with something or whatever, that's what I put into the music.
Fuck with G and get some money. No limit, I'm a fucking soldier. Ay, always lit, yeah, I'm never sober. Just for 3 days in a row, y'all bitch coming over. Told that bitch to kick rock, she act like it's a boulder. Ay, yeah, fuck with me and get some money.
Showtime about 2 hours.
We get that, man.
Yes, sir.
Oh, you're recording.
Oh. It's all good, man. I'm here promoting. Pushing the movement, man. Sweating G's.
12 years ago, I was standing in downtown Oakland selling mixtapes with a CD player asking people walking by, like, support local hip hop. I've had to work to get my voice heard in music. I've had to hone my craft and, like, work at all that. I knew as a little kid that, you know, I looked at my parents and said, I don't want to live like this. My mom did everything she could to, you know, supply and provide for me and my little brother, and she scraped to get by. She worked two jobs, and I promised myself that, you know, somehow, some way, I would make it to some point in life, and I would give back, and that I would take us further.
Where you're from, that's your roots, that's your identity, that's your DNA, that's your whole, like, worldview, your perspective, and what you represent, and where you're from, is...
That's where your first fans are from.
First. I remember those shows in Berkeley at La Peña. Like, we sold out La Peña, like, 200 people. It's not even a venue. And they booked me because nowhere else in the Bay would book me. And I was emailing venues myself. I think I even lied. I was like, hi, I represent an artist named G-Eazy. Like, my name's Gerald. I'd like to book my artist at your venue at this day. And I remember it was venues in the Bay that said, like, we don't think your artist is quite big enough. Like, why don't you play a few more spots and come back to us when you're ready?
I didn't want to play there anyway.
So I was doing my signing in the Bay, Amoeba in Berkeley on Telegraph Avenue. And the nostalgia of, like, being at the same, like, CD store. And I'm dating myself, I'm saying kids don't go to CD stores, but that's what we did. And it's just so crazy to follow the journey. I was just so overwhelmed.
MySpace.com/BayboyMusic, bro. I can't make this shit up. He bought this shit from me at Top Dog in 06, bro, in North Oakland. Let's go, bro. That's great. I designed this shit on Photoshop myself, and I made the beats. Damn.
For me, I think, obviously, like,
I look different, my whole image, my style, my everything, my sound different. You know, I didn't fit any conventional box. I would have been signed earlier if I did. You know, labels wanna like, we're just gonna do what we did with this guy. We're gonna follow the same formula. I didn't follow no fucking formula. I don't know if it wasn't worth the risk or if the music wasn't there yet or anything, whatever.
Zonk the fuck out.
Point blank, it didn't work for me.
Next time, tell my fucking manager, Matt Bauschmidt, to argue for not only a bathroom on the tour bus to brush our teeth, but a flyer tour bus.
It didn't work the traditional route until I got it popping on my own on YouTube.
No dreams too big, chase anything, got the passion to do. Only a dream till it happens to you. Finally seeing money, now I'm acting a fool. Never thought touring the world all year would be something I might actually do. Yeah.
I'm forever grateful of the opportunity that that presented to an artist like myself without the resources of a major label.
Dude, do you write in hieroglyphs or some shit?
Like, I definitely have a love-hate with going out. I have a love-hate with partying. I have a love-hate with the attention I get because of who I am. I have a love-hate with, like, you know, it's like when you're hella, like, excited and it's the best day of your life, it's like it goes hella fast and then you blink and it's over. And it's like, that irony is so crazy because you don't get to live it because it's just a moment. It's like, you know, blink and it'll be, like, a month from now. You just gotta, like, you gotta do the work and prove your worth, you know, in music especially.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Bay Area's very own multi-platinum recording artist! Make some noise for G-Eazy-O!
It's like anything else. You wanna get better at what you're doing. You study, you work at it, you know what I mean? That's technique. But it's such, like, an honest form of expression of self that confidence and all that, you know, comes from where you're at in life. You know what I mean? I bought every sneaker I wanted to collect, every Nike SB. Like, I got my mom a spot. Like, I got this house, I got this studio. Like, I did these things. There's a confidence that comes with, like, starting a Ferrari and being like, that's life. In a sense, it's exactly as advertised. It is what it is, you know? Like, it is that crazy. But you can, like, you can have an idea of what it is, you can be told what it is, and then when you get there, there's nothing that can prepare you for actually being in the driver's seat and then doing it.
Drop out a little more lows, a little more compression and a little reverb. Yeah. And I kind of think it started to pop off for me a little bit, but it wasn't quite there yet. Something like that. Yeah. Yeah, scrambling, trying to figure out. Went back to the drawing board. No, they say rejection's only supposed to make you want it more. But no lie, you contemplating quitting, walking out the door. But what the fuck you supposed to do? This is all you living for. Really, it was that in death. That was all you had. Barely getting by, hella broke. You was doing bad. Then these things happen. You finally seen a bag. You drove down the highway, a fork in the road. A normal life for her, or going for broke. I seen an open lane and then I drove straight through it. If it was easy, everyone would do it. This game is not easy. Yeah.
It's really, really, really insanely fucking hard to make it in music. So knowing that the odds are against you and knowing that you stand a chance to, you know, invest all of this and take all of these risks, put all this time and energy in, put yourself on the line, you'll probably lose and you probably won't make it. This is art. This is music. This is literally like a creative form that we cherish and like there's only so many people that supply it for us. And I just approach things I make with that kind of attitude of like trying to push things forward.
The authenticity of the artist is always in question in this music. But I do think those of us that love this music were always going, nah, that shit is that. That's that bullshit. Mm-hmm. No, that's that real shit. Nah, he's paid his.
Well, I think there's a reason. G-Eazy hasn't really caught any hate, right? Because I think people.
A, you go check his credentials in the right. Bay, people be like, nah, it's G-Eazy. Yeah. Love. It's
all A, good. He's himself. B, he's been putting in the work for years. And most importantly, he can rap.
I found how to cope with my anger. I'm swimming in money. Swimming in liquor. My liver is muddy. But it's all good. I'm still sipping this bubbly. Mission is lovely. Mission ain't random. I think you're lucky. I made the right hit because I'm sick with it cutting. They take the money for granted. But don't want to work for it. Tell me now, isn't it funny?
Platforms like YouTube provide an opportunity to connect with fans in a way that didn't exist before. If you're not active on YouTube, if you're not visible, if you're not giving that window into your life at all, then you just disappear. You know, somebody could be the biggest thing in the world and you take too much of a step back, you know, you disappear for too long and they forget about you.
Hey, I do this shit cause I turn it up a little bit. I got a block. Yo. I might go fuck up these bands. Ay, I do this shit cause I can. Yeah, I just took care of my fam. Ay, thought this was always the plan. Yeah, I might go fly to Japan. Ay, Honolulu get a tan. Yeah, to the beach I don't bring sand. No, thought that was always the plan. Ay, call me when you need a hand, yeah. In the Bay, I'm Superman, ay. YSL on me, goddamn, tell me why is your girlfriend my number one fan?
I just put out my third album, you know what I mean? Like, the past two have plaques, you know what I mean? Like, platinum, both. Like, this one will for sure go platinum, you know what I mean? Like, we did that three times in a row. So now it's like, I think more than anything, now it's like where it starts. Now it's like, okay, you're here. You know what I mean? You have this platform you always dreamed of. You have, you know, the whole world watching. I'm public and vulnerable, and this is just me expressing myself, my true self, and putting it out there for the world in this form.
Damn, that's fire.
I remember making that YouTube account in like 2008. Jeezy TV, why the fuck is it called that? But this is legit.
You know, there are people watching and listening and waiting and paying attention, and I think that's all a creative could ever dream of. To have somebody on the other side waiting to experience what you create.
All right, let's go work.